بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله عز وجل به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد. الحمد لله. My respected brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the best gift He gives to anyone in the world, which is the gift of deen, this gift of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. And alhamdulillah, most of us, the majority of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of this kalima, because of this kalima of tawheed, this la ilaha illallah in your heart, there is good in you, there is khair in our hearts. However, one of the biggest diseases we are facing nowadays in our time, and one of the main reasons why we struggle to practice our deen, is because our faith and our iman in the unseen is extremely weak. We know that we're all gonna die. So if I ask any of you, can you die tonight? Can you die tomorrow? Can tonight be your last night? Can tomorrow morning be your last morning? The answer is no, yes. But there's a huge difference between having this knowledge in your brain and having this belief in your heart. The realization how close death is to you is an issue that people are negligent of. Death is a known fact. We all know that we will die, and if you ask anyone, Muslim or non-Muslim, regardless of his religion, can you die? Are you dying? He's gonna say 100% the day will come when I will die. This is yaqeen, this is belief that everyone has. It's a known fact, but most of human beings are negligent of, or they choose to forget it. We choose, our choice is to neglect this fact, to put it on the side. This is why usually we have a tendency of not liking or disliking the issue of death being brought up. If you're in a gathering and someone keeps saying death, 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 what will the action be? Please, brother, you know, change the topic. You made us sad, you depressed us. So we have this tendency of disliking the topic of death and liking topic of dunya. We like topic of dunya. Someone speaks about dunya, about this world, its decorations, all its entertainment, and as such, we love it. We'll talk for hours and hours and hours about this world. But when someone speaks about the akhirah, we get bored. When someone speaks about the hereafter, we get bored. Someone brings the issue of death, the issue of the qabr, the grave, the issue of the mizan, the scales of judgment day, the issue of facing Allah and meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have this tendency of, Allah's half an hour, 45 minutes, once every Friday, maybe a youth talk every now and then, but more than that, it becomes, brother, this is too much now. This is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised his ummah. He sallallahu was haris al ummah. He used to care for this ummah, his students sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he used to say, أكثروا من ذكر هذه من اللذات. Always, always, continuously, abundantly, always keep discussing the issue and bring up the issue of death. أكثروا من ذكر هذه من اللذات يعني الموت. The destroyer of pleasures. Rasulullah called what? The destroyer of pleasures. Death, whenever a calamity happens, if any calamity befalls you, لا يذكر الموت في ضيق إلا وسع. When death is mentioned in a hard situation, a calamity befalls you, you're in rough times, what do you say? If the issue of death becomes brought up, what happens? You get relaxed. Why? Because whatever you are suffering is much less than death. And death makes you relieved. So we're dying one day, we're all dying one day. وَلَا يُذْكَرْ فِي سَعَةٍ إِلَّا ضَيَّقَةٍ. And when death is mentioned in the time of ease, what happens? It makes the person uneasy. Uneasy. Why bring something now unhappy? it's my wedding, we have a party, we're enjoying our time. So this death does miracles to human beings. The reason why me and you are struggling to bring the complete deen in our life is that shaitan has managed one way or the other, the devil has managed one way or the other to trick us that death is very, very far from you. Death is not coming now. You're not dying tonight, you're not dying tomorrow, you're not dying in a week, you're still living. طول الأمل, as Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم described it. طول الأمل. The human being has what? Has long and very, very big hopes in life. I will still live. I will do this. I will grow up. I will see my kids grow up. I will take them to university. I will get them married. I will do this business. I will do this. Long hopes. And death is reality. Reality is this death, that we're all facing it. And it might be closer to you than what you think. How many times have all of us, it happened to most of us, that you know a friend of yours, young in age, youth, mashallah, especially here in Sydney, happens a lot of times. He was with me yesterday. Wallah, 1 week ago we were out together. This happened and that happened then. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Car accident, shooting, problems, sickness. He just died. And then we get affected for a while. Subhanallah. He was my close friend. We get affected for a bit. But then what happens? Quickly we forget. We pray janazah. Everyone is there. If you're a close member of family, you see the body. You see it being washed. You see them, the taghseel. And then our hearts get touched. But then this doesn't last. 1 day, 2 days, and life goes on. We forget again that death might be very close. This is why the ulama say, احذروا التسويف فإن الموت يأتي بغتة. Beware from saying, I will do, I will make tawbah, I will come close, inshallah I have intentions. Beware of saying, سوف أفعل, I will do. فإن الموت يأتي, because death comes suddenly. Death is not going to wait for you. When your time comes, see, you can't take an extra second. You can't add an extra second to your life. This is why it is extremely important that this issue is always fresh in our brains. This is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, was asked by a man of the Ansar, one of the Ansar people of Medina, he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is the best of believers, ya Rasulullah? Who is the best of believers? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أحسنهم خلقا. The one of them that has the best of manners. And then this man asked him, ya Rasulullah, so who is the most smartest of the believers? Who is the most smartest? Who is the smartest of the believers? Who's Akyas, Aftan, this brain power? So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أكثرهم ذكرا للموت. The smartest of the believers is the what? Is the person that remembers death a lot. So long as you are remembering death, this brings you closer to Allah. This makes you understand that you are departing. You're not living in this world forever. This wife might not be your wife. These kids might not be your kids. You are moving on. You are not here to stay. You are here for temporarily, for a short period. And this is what we need to always, talk of. Bring this issue up to bring this, understanding that how short it is our life and how close death is to us. Judgment Day, how long is Judgment Day? 50,000 years. 50,000 years. And our life? 60-70 years. So our life is very short. So when we see death, when we see the grave, this makes our hearts softer. Like this is why Rasulullah said, I had banned you from visiting the graves. At the beginning, visiting the graves was not allowed in Islam. And then Rasulullah said, I banned you from visiting the graves, but now you are allowed to go visit the graves. أَلَا فَزُهُرُوهَا. Now visit it. Why? فَإِنَّهَا تُذَكِّرُكُمُ الْأَخِرَةِ. Because graves remind you of the hereafter. Graves remind you of death. Now this death that we, unfortunately nowadays, we are negligent of, is not something easy, my brothers. Wallahi al-azim, if we realize the seriousness of the matter, we will not take our deen so easily. We will not deal with the orders of Allah and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so softly. We will be, more attentive, more concentrating, more attempts to bring this complete deen in our lives. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the best and the most perfect man to ever walk on this earth, suffered صلى الله عليه وسلم in his death. On his deathbed, صلى الله عليه وسلم, as the Sahaba and Aisha رضي الله عنها narrate, that he صلى الله عليه وسلم was struggling in his سكرات الموت, the pains of death. So even Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم suffered from the pains of death. And in the narration, he صلى الله عليه وسلم had a container of water beside him. He used to put his hands and wipe his face صلى الله عليه وسلم with it, and says, لا إله إلا الله إن للموت سكرات. Verily, death has pains. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was struggling at that moment, at that point of change when you are departing this world and moving to the real life, real reality. ألا لا إله إلا الله إن للموت سكرات. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was in pain صلى الله عليه وسلم. If Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم suffered, what will be our condition? How will we face that point? Unfortunately, no one came back from the dead to tell us, you know, how he felt, how much he struggled. But we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, and Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم told us, that this moment is not easy, my brothers. This moment of death is extremely hard. And everyone, any smart person, has to live and work hard to prepare for that day, to prepare for that moment. So my brothers, يعني, please bear in mind that if Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم struggled as such, if Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was in pain, I should work hard. I should do my best to relieve myself from this pain, to have, you know, an easy death, as we say. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained to us in the Quran and told us and described to us the condition of the person when he reaches that moment. It is extremely hard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ, in Surah Qaf. Very, very famous. We all know the surah, mashallah. وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ. The pains of death brought reality. وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدٌ. This is what you were running away from, trying to escape from, staying away from. You are trying to avoid this reality. What's the reality? The reality of this world. The reality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created you for this test. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to ask you. That you will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you about every word you said. Everything you heard, every step you made, you'll be asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this reality, some people are negligent of. So what does death bring? وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدٍ. This is what you used to run away from. وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْوَعِيدِ. And Israfil عليه السلام blows in the trumpet, in the sur. ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْوَعِيدِ. This is the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fulfill the promise He promised the infidels and the kuffar and the mujrimeen. The wa'id, He warned them. سبحانه وتعالى ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد. And every نفس, every soul in this world, king or beggar, يعني old, whatever, male, female, will come on judgment day. وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد. An angel that's dragging it, taking it. No one is allowed. There's no freedom at that time. No freedom on judgment day. No one can walk whenever he wish, do whatever he wish, go wherever he wish. Don't think that you will say, you know, I want to go to the Hawd of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Hawd al-Kawthar, and it's easy. It's not easy. Billions and billions of human beings, barefooted, uncircumcised, naked, running around like crazy. وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى. They appear as if they are drunk. وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى. But they are not drunk. وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ. The punishment of Allah is severe. And on that day, everyone has an angel dragging him, taking him to court. And the shaheed, and the witness. A witness on your a'mal, on your actions. If you lie, he's there standing. كذبت, you lied. So what happened? That's not what you did. This is not what you had in your heart. سائق وشهيد. لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا. You were negligent. You were in negligence, heedlessness of these facts, of this reality. فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ. Today, we have lifted the veils Now you can see. فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد. Today you have sharp sight. And how does the person see? The person sees with his heart, my brothers. We don't see with our eyes. Allah says in the Quran, وَمَنْ كَانَ فِي هَذِهِ أَعْمَى فَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ أَعْمَى وَأَضَلُّ سَبِيلَهِ وَأَضَلُّ سَبِيلَهِ He who is blind in this world will be blind on judgment day. Yeah, subhanAllah, a person is blind, Allah gave him eyesight. Is he going to be punished on judgment day? Of course not. Blind meaning what? His heart is blind. He did not see reality. He never took this deen seriously. He took it as a joke. لَهُ وَلَعِبْ لَهُ وَلَعِبْ Me play an enjoyment in this world as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not judge you. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not bring you to account. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not ask you about your salawat, about the Quran, about the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not something light. It's something huge. So that day, the person that was blind by his heart in this world will also be blind on judgment day. You'll also be blind then. Imagine in this fee, and you are blind and you can't see. فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَى الْأَبْصَارِ Allah says in the Quran, فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَى الْأَبْصَارِ Verily, it's not the eyes or the sight that gets blind. فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَى الْأَبْصَارِ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَى الْقُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ What gets blind are the hearts in the chests of human beings. They get blind. They can't see. So ask yourself, does my heart see in this world? Do I realize the reality? Do I realize the seriousness of the matter? Even if you don't, on that second and that day, when the veils will be lifted, everyone will know. Everyone will know his position. Me, you, the sinner, the pious, everyone will know the value of a'mal, the reward of reading Quran, the reward of salawat, the reward of lowering your gaze, the reward of praying tahajjud at night, the reward of fasting, and the seriousness of backbiting, the seriousness of making fun of others, the seriousness of not praying, the seriousness of being negligent from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everyone will realize reality at the time. Everyone will have a sharp sight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes people, the hearts nowadays, Allah is saying to us, but we read the Quran, and unfortunately, we don't ponder over its meanings. We don't really understand what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَلَّا بَلْ تُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَ This is the Quran, this is the message Rasulullah brought to us. How is it that we Muslims nowadays, we don't read the Quran with understanding. We don't have a share. We don't have a relationship with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Unfortunately, especially the youth in this country, we find, oh, wallahi, Shaykh, I don't know how to read Quran. Oh, I lost my Arabic tongue. I can't speak Arabic anymore. Wallahi, wallahi, wallahi. The person that does not know how to speak the Arabic language, that does not understand the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is extremely deprived. You do not know what you are missing. You have no idea what you are missing out on. Understanding directly and freshly the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without an intermediary, without a translation or someone to explain, just reading the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these are extremely heavy words. Your hearts are deprived. Why? Because we lost our Arabic tongue. We are not serious anymore. SubhanAllah, some people, for dunya reasons, they will go, now mashallah, they will learn a different language for work. Tah? English language now. Why is English language spread all over the world? Everyone, English, 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 why? Because it's the language of business, language of trade. If you want to go anywhere, you speak English, alhamdulillah, now we can communicate. Why? Because of money, capitalism. But Arabic language, the language of the Quran, even the Arabs, migrants to this country are losing. The generations are what? Losing the language. Why? We don't understand. Allah is saying to us, to me and you, it's not only to the Sahaba and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to me and you, كَلَّا بَلْ تُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَ You love this short word, this fast word. We love it. Allah is saying that you love it. كَلَّا بَلْ تُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَ وَتَذَرُونَ الْآخِرَةِ And you neglect and you leave the hereafter. Neglect the hereafter and you want what? This world. Where is our focus? What's our concern? This world. كلا بل تحبون العاجلة وتذرون الآخرة. And you neglect the hereafter. But what's the reality? What will we see when the veils are lifted? وجوه يومئذ ناضرة. Some faces on Judgment Day will have light, radiant. وجوه يومئذ ناضرة. Happy, enjoying. إلى ربها ناظرة. They can see the Lord. The best gift Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give to any human being on earth is to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Jannah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lifts the veils and people of Jannah see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what does the hadith say? فَمَا أُعْطُوا شَيْئًا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّظَرِ إِلَى وَجْهِ رَبِّهِمْ. They realized that after taking everything in paradise, there was nothing compared to the na'im, to the يعني amusement and the beauty of seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing is equal to that. اللهم لا تحرمنا لذة النظر إلى وجهك الكريم. Ya Allah, don't deprive us from the sweetness of looking at you subhanahu. So imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing some faces on that day where وجوه يومئذ ناظرة إلى ربها ناظرة ووجوه يومئذ باسرة. And some faces on that day are in depression, باسرة, upset, sad, crying blood. تظن أن يفعل بها فقرة. They know what they will face. تظن أن يفعل بها فقرة. They know the punishment Allah has prepared for them. تظن أن يفعل بها فقرة. كلا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes them death. كلا إذا بلغت التراقي. Verily, when the ruh, when the spirit reaches the collarbone. كلا إذا بلغت التراقي وقيل من راق. And then when the person realizes death has come, now no doctor can save me, no hospital can do anything. Death, خلاص, he feels the spirit leaving. كلا إذا بلغت التراقي. والله, what a moment, if we only understand. وقيل من راق. And that, he started screaming. Everyone, the family is begging, anyone do ruqya on him. Heal him any way, any form, any sort, please. وقيل من راق وظن أنه الفراق. And then he realized the reality. وظن أنه الفراق, that he is leaving. إلى ربك يومئذ المساق. Verily, everyone is returning to your Lord that day. إلى ربك يومئذ المساق. So we should all prepare for that moment. We should all be smart. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم described the hal and the condition of the pious people, religious people, people that feared Allah, people that were smart in this world. What was the condition? When they pass away, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy for them. Rasulullah says in the hadith that when the pious Muslim passes away, خلاص, what happens? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the angels descend. Angels from paradise, they descend. Malaikat al-Rahm, the angels of peace, of mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they descend and their faces are radiant like the sun and they spread until the last point your eyes can see, the deceased person can see. And then the angel of death comes and stands, you know, just where his head is. And these angels have with them shrouds from paradise and perfume that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for that moment. Perfume from paradise. And then the angel of death speaks to the soul, says, leave, ayatuha ar-ruh at-tayyibah, you good soul, leave the body of this pious slave. Ila rabbin radin anki ghayr ghadban, to a Lord that's happy with you, pleased with you, leave the body. And then the moment the ruh leaves, how does it leave? Like Rasulullah s.a.w. describes, like a water, like a drop of water leaves, you know, a qirba or a siqa of ma, you know, like a leather container of water, pouch of water, as such. It leaves very, very slightly, very, very softly, no pain, no harm, at ease, in tranquility, in peace. And then the angels directly grab it and they raise with it to the skies. They go up to Samawat al-Saba', and then everyone from Mala' al-A'la is greeting this soul by the best of the names. Who's this? Who's the owner of this beautiful, beautiful smelling, you know, soul that's coming? And then they say, Fulan ibn Fulan, so and so, you know, the pious slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And All this, you know, ceremony is made for him until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes him descend back to the grave to be tested. But if this person is not pious, not religious, never practiced his deen, was negligent of the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what's the situation? How will he face death? The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us that the angels will come from Jahannam and they will have shrouds from Jahannam. And the worst scent, the worst smell you can ever smell in your life. And the angel of death will grab his soul, the description that was made, his soul will run away to the limbs of his body. It doesn't want to leave. And then the angel of death will have to actually grab it and pull it out by force. And the pain is like a thorn that's been taken out of wet wool. Imagine wet wool and the thorn is tearing that wool apart to come out. This is how this person will suffer. And then the angels will grab this soul and take it into this, you know, this shroud from Jahannam and torture, and everything gets always worse. All get worse and worse and worse. So where do you want to be? Why aren't we smart enough to realize that this matter is serious, that moment is extremely important? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in another surah, وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذِ الظَّالِمُونَ فِي غَمَرَاتِ الْمَوْتِ. If only you can see, Allah is describing to me and you, if only you can see the sinners, the wrongdoers, the oppressors, فِي غَمَرَاتِ الْمَوْتِ, in the hardships of death. If only you can see that sight. وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ بَاسِطُوا أَيْدِيهِمْ أَخْرِجُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. The angels have spread their hands to this, you know, person, smashing him, hitting him, harming him, humiliating him. أخرجوا أنفسكم, get your souls out. اليوم تجزون عذاب الهون. Today, you will receive the shameful punishment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for you. اليوم تجزون عذاب الهون بما كنتم, but because of what you used to do, the arrogance you used to live with, the negligence you used to live in. You used to neglect the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, neglect the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, neglect the warnings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then they say, وَلَقَدْ جِئْتُمُونَ فُرَادًا كَمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ وَتَرَقْتُمْ مَا خَوَّلْنَاكُمْ وَرَاءَ ظُهُورِكُمْ. Today, you have come to us alone. Where are your friends? Where are your mates? Where is your family? Can anyone help you now? Can anyone assist you now? People you sacrifice your life for. Sometimes we sacrifice our lives for you know, people around us, and we don't know what we're sacrificing. You're sacrificing your akhirah. On that day, وَلَقَدْ جِئْتُمُونَا فُرَادًا, alone, كَمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ, like we created you in the beginning, the first time. وَمَا نَرَى مَعَكُمْ شُفَعَاءَكُمُ الَّذِينَ زَعَمْتُمْ أَنَّهُمْ فِيكُمْ شُرَكَاءَ. Where are your intercessors? Where are your شُفَعَاء? Where are your partners that you claimed will save you on that day? وَمَا نَرَى مَعَكُمْ شُفَعَاءَكُمُ الَّذِينَ زَعَمْتُمْ أَنَّهُمْ فِيكُمْ شُرَكَاءَ لَقَدْ تَقَطَّعَ بَيْنَكُمْ وَضَلَّ عَنْكُمْ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَزْعُمُونَ. Today, all relationships has been cut. Everyone. الْأَخِلَّاءُ, friends, best mates on Judgment Day, how will they be? الْأَخِلَّاءُ يَوْمَئِذٍ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌّ. On that day, best mates become what? Enemies. Best mates that are not on deen. They were not on deen. They used to, you know, now we have gangs, mashallah. We gang. The Muslim youth, the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is what? Now we're working out gangs. We the boys. The boys gang. Why do they gather? They gather for deen? No, we gather for sin. We gather for disobedience of Allah. Instead of being examples for the world, the Muslim youth are now examples of sin. We, mashallah, we beat the non-Muslims in sin nowadays. Alright? So this relationship, this friendship, wallah, I'll die for my brother, I will die for my mate. If he goes down, I'm going down. We always hear these claims. Wallahi al-azim, these are all lies. All kadhib, all fake. Why? Allah said in the Quran, Al-akhillau yawma'idhin ba'duhum li ba'din adawu. They will be enemies on Judgment Day. Illa al-muttaqeen, except for the pious, the religious, people that love each other for the sake of Allah. So where do you want to be? What sort of death do you want to look for? What sort of connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are you building? These are the questions that made the Sahaba radiallahu anhum concerned. This is what made the Sahaba radiallahu anhum sleepless at nights. They were thinking, how can we please Allah? How can we have such a happy ending. On that day when you die, you think it's easy. You don't see. We don't see what's happening. But subhanAllah, as the scholars say, shaitan is standing there on the head of the dead person. While he's dying, the last seconds of his life. What happens? In the last seconds of his life, shaitan comes to you with extreme power and strength. The last seconds of your life, his last chance. And what does he say to you? Accept Judaism, it's the best religion. Become Christian, it's the best religion. I'm giving you advice, I'm warning you. Last seconds, you will die, you will pass away. Big, big fitna, a big, big test. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only helps and assists who? The pious people that fear Allah. يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes who strong, makes who steadfast at that moment? The pious. He gives them la ilaha illallah. They're able to say, ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah in that hard moment. Some people, we've seen them, we've heard of them. He's dying, he's passing away. People around him are saying, say la ilaha illallah. He says, take care of my kids. Say la ilaha illallah, my company. Take care of my kids, my car. Do this with my money, do this. Why? No deen. He never lived on deen. Never practiced the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wasn't sure, his life was always full of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why on that day, no help, no assistance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the pious has prepared a beautiful reward. On that, in these moments, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down the angels for the pious. Inna alladhina qalu rabbuna Allah. People that said rabbuna Allah, our Lord is Allah, our Rabb is Allah. Thumma istaqamu. And then they were steadfast on deen. Steadfast on the religion, practicing the orders of Allah, practicing deen, following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Inna alladhina qalu rabbuna Allah thumma istaqamu, and then they were steadfast. Tatanazzalu alayhim al-malaika, angels descend on them. Tatanazzalu alayhim al-malaika alla takhafu wa la tahzanu wa abshiru bil jannati allati kuntum tu'adun. Don't be afraid, don't worry, don't be concerned, don't be sad. Alla takhafu wa la tahzanu. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُعَدُونَ. We give you glad tidings of the paradise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared and promised for you. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُعَدُونَ. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. We were your supporters, your allies in this world and in the next. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ. خلاص, the test is over. Now, enjoy. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ. Whatever your soul desire, whatever you want, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ. Whatever you ask for, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give. Now is the time of completing your desires. You struggled in this world to follow the orders of Allah. Now is the time of the present. Imagine, some people on the deathbed, they see the angels. This is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, Man ahabba liqa Allah, ahabba Allahu liqa. Whoever loves to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah loves to meet him. So Aisha radiallahu anha wondered, said, oh Prophet of Allah, how does everyone love to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Some people, they hate death. وَمَنْ كَرِهَ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ كَرِهَ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَ. She said, أَكَرَهِيَةُ الْمَوْتِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Hatred of death, we all hate death. So Rasulullah said, no, it's not the hatred of death. But when the believer is in the last seconds of his life, when he's khalas about to die, he receives the glad tidings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before you die, Allah shows you where you're going. You know what will happen to you. You receive the glad tidings of paradise, the angels come and greet you and salute you as such. So what happens? He sees reality. So he says, he wants to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now. He wants to meet Allah. فَأَحَبَّ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَ. وَمَنْ كَرِهَ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ. The person that did not practice this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on his deathbed, he will receive also the air. He will realize, the results of his actions and realize the seriousness of the matter, and then he will hate to meet Allah, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hate to meet him. This is why also Rasulullah said in the hadith, إِذَا وُضِعَتِ الْجَنَازَةِ وَاحْتَمَلَهَا الرِّجَالِ. When the funeral is set and then the men carry it on the shoulders and on the necks and it starts walking, فَإِنْ كَانَتْ صَالِحًا. If it was a pious funeral, a pious man, what does it say? قَالَتْ قَدِّمُونِي قَدِّمُونِي. Take me, quickly, run, rush. Why? He wants to go to Jannah. He wants to go to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared. He worked hard in this world. Now he deserves the present, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the gift Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for him. قدموني قدموني وإن كانت غير ذلك. If it's not صالحة, not a pious person, what they say? قالت يا ويلها أين تذهبون بها. Woe to it. Where are you taking it? Where are you taking me? Leave me. I want to return back to this world. I want to return back to my money, my family, my business. يا ويلها أين تذهبون بها. It screams such a scream. If any human being hears it, he will faint. And all human beings don't hear it. Everything in the world hears this scream, except for what? الثقلان, the jinn and the ins. The jinn and human beings. They are the ones that don't hear it. So my brothers, we should be smart. Wallahi al-azim deen, yani, is very, our deen is extremely, extremely logical. If we only have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to, Allah speaks to the people in the Quran and says, فَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. Don't you think? أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ, people that have hearts, does anyone have brains to think? Why? Why? Why does a person sell the akhirah to buy this world? Absolutely a wrong decision. To sell the akhirah and take this world. What a wrong deal. What an ugly and bad deal. Why? Why? For 60 years, to be happy 60 years, you leave everlasting happiness? Or you take everlasting torture? Why? Be smart. Ali radiallahu anhu. وكرم الله وجهه. Once he went to visit the graves. He went and visited the graveyard. And then when he was there, he called out. And he says, Assalamu alaikum dar qawm al-mu'minin. He gave salam to the graveyard and then said, should we tell you what happened or should you tell us? What happened after you passed away? Should we tell you or should you tell us? He said, I will say, your money has been distributed. It was given out to what? The inheritors. All this money you worked hard for, where did it go? Your money was given, distributed between the heirs, your inheritors. And your wives got married. And your houses, someone else is living in them now. And then Ali radiallahu anhu looked to people with him and said, if they were able to speak, do you know what they will say? He said, what will they say? He said, they will say, verily, verily, if only we had the zad of taqwa. There's nothing as this, as piety of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If only we worked hard to bring this taqwa in our life, fear of Allah and piety in our lives, we would have been successful. We would have been happy. We would have realized, you know, we'd have seen what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for the pious. Harun al-Rashid, a king. None of us now, يعني, most of us are not as rich as this man. This man was a king, يعني, Allahu Akbar, the Abbasid Khilafah at the time was at its peak. Riches and money that never came to the Muslim world before. Harun Rashid, a very, very famous and big king in the history of Islam. When death came, what happened? In the narration, Harun Rashid, when he was in his deathbed, he told to his family, take me to the grave that I'll be buried in. They carried him. And they took him to the grave that he'll be buried in. And then when he saw the grave, he started crying. Imagine seeing your own grave, your real abode, where are you going? So when he saw the grave, he started crying. And then said, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. That's where I'm at. That's where I'm going. And then what did he say? He said, Ma aghna anni sultaniya. What did my kingdom do? Halaka anni maliya. Ma aghna anni sultaniya. My money is gone. My kingdom is gone. What happened? And then he looked to the skies and made dua and said, Ya man la yazulu mulkuh, irham man qad zala mulkuh. O you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whom his kingdom never perishes, have mercy on the king that his kingdom has perished. My kingdom is gone. Now I'm like everyone else in the world. So we should be, me and you, should yani, try our best. Before death comes, before you don't know it, and death hits you, be smart. Make tawbah, return to Allah. Why are we dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like this? Allah gave us the best deen, the best Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Easiest sharia, easiest legislations Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. And still we choose not to practice. Still we choose the path of shaitan and leave the path of Rahman. Why? Why not pray? Wallah, the salawat were 50. Salah was originally 50 salawat. Allah made them 5. 50 in reward and 5 in practice. How easy, how merciful is Allah. And then we do sin, we disobey Allah, we leave the sunnah of Rasulullah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Oh you, my slaves who have, you know, done sin, you know, broken the orders of Allah, passed the borders of Allah, don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah forgives all sins. إِنَّهُ وَالْغَفُورُ رَحِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most merciful. Why choose to be away from Allah and not choose to be close to Allah? So all of us, before death comes, should be smart. Make tawbah. Return to Allah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Tubu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha. All you who believe, repent to Allah. Return to Allah. A proper and sincere repentance. This is what we need to come back to the houses of Allah. Follow the sunnah of Allah, of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Return to the deserted book of Allah, the Quran. Start learning, understanding. Learn the Arabic language like we said. Try to understand and have knowledge of your deen. And practice your deen and call and invite others to the deen of Allah. This should be the target of every youth, every mashallah. We're full of energy, full of power. But we are, where are we putting this energy? In the wrong place. Instead of putting it for deen, serving the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, serving Islam, we are wasting our lives, wasting our youth, wasting our energy. Why? For nothing. And then we regret. Then we regret. And say, Yaret, I wish I'd done this. I wish I'd done that. I wish I practiced more. I wish I learned more. So, yani, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us understanding and to make us really realize that death might be closer than what you think. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the right path in this time of fitna and to allow us to be pious slaves of His subhanahu wa ta'ala and to make us follow properly the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best man to ever walk on this earth. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaj'alna min alladhina yastami'una al-qawla fayattabi'una ahsana. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant astaghfiruka.